Welcome back. Bringing your lunch to work or school isn't only a great way to perhaps save money, but also save some calories by planning healthy, delicious meals. Guess it depends on your taste, tailored to your dietary needs and your taste buds. Six is on call this afternoon with Elmwood Fitness Center dietitian Molly Kimball. She has ideas for healthy, cost-effective lunches. Molly, great to see you. I was just reading your article in the paper.
Good, thanks.
You always have some good information for us. It takes a little planning to bring your own lunch. So what are the main benefits?
Well, the main benefits, the obvious ones for people, it's going to save you time, it's going to save you money. But from a nutritional standpoint, it also gives you more control over your lunch.
Look, around midday, especially, you know, we wake up a little early around here in the news business, but a lot of people at home get to that mid-morning slump or midday slump. Do you have any foods that you would recommend that could actually help with that?
Yeah, there's nothing worse getting back to your desk, you know, starting running your errands in the afternoon and you're exhausted. You want to take a nap. So you want to limit how much white carbs you have at lunch. You don't want to have a lot of white carbs. You're going to have that crash, that drop of energy afterwards. So whole grain carbs when you do have them at lunch, but making sure you include protein with your lunch. That's going to increase your alertness. Also, a little bit of fat will actually keep you feeling fuller longer. Not too much fat, though, or it can leave you sluggish as well.
All right, I'm getting kind of stressed out thinking about that because that does require a lot of planning. Do you have any tips for some easy meals to put together?
Well, the sandwich is a favorite, or it's the most common one for a reason because it's so super easy. But there's ways that
you can't use
it.
White bread, right?
Right. You don't want to use white bread. You want to do whole grain bread if possible. But you don't always have to even have turkey between two slices of bread. You could use pitas. You could use bagels. You could use wraps. Or you can scratch the bread altogether and do something like chicken salad, tuna salad with a whole grain cracker. But changing up those breads so it's not always sliced breads, changing the meat so it's not always turkey. It could be roast beef, ham, chicken, change the cheeses, Gouda, Asiago, get fancy with it, and the spreads. You could do guacamole as a spread instead of a light mayonnaise, or pesto, hummus.
Yeah, those are great ideas. So if you didn't know if wheat was healthier, there's your answer right there.
Right.
What about any common mistakes that you see among people who try to pack light lunches?
There's two key things. One, they'll go really light, and they'll pack something like a carton of light yogurt. A carton of yogurt about this size, it has less protein than one egg, and it can have as much sugar as 7 packs of sugar. So what happens is people bring a carton of yogurt like this, a piece of fruit, 100-calorie pack, and they wonder why they're hungry later. The other thing people will bring is frozen dinners. So if you do bring a frozen dinner, what I'll always say is look at the label, try to make sure you've got at least 20 grams of protein. That gives you the equivalent of about 3 ounces of meat. That will keep you full. A lot of frozen diet dinners don't have nearly enough protein.
All right, some great information there. Help clear up a little bit of myths. I just made you a doctor, Molly. Molly Kimball, she's a dietitian over there at Elmwood Fitness Center. She always has great information, and you can find her information everywhere here, including on WDSU.com. Molly, thanks so much for joining us.